ladies and gentlemen, this match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Romania, weighing 235 pounds, Johnny K9. His opponent, now about to enter the ring area, from Florida, weighing 265 pounds, Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff.
Tremendous standing ovation for Mr. Wonderful. The man walking around with a $50,000 bounty right on top of his head. Compliments of Bobby the Brain Heenan.
You notice, Gorilla, he stopped, he took a look at me.
Yeah, if looks could kill, Jess, you'd be a goner right now.
That's all fine and dandy, but that just shows you how worried this man Orndorff is. Well, look at his face, look at him close. Look at all the wrinkles he's gotten in about the last month or two. He's aging fast, Gorilla.
It's obvious that this is weighing on him very heavily, and he knows, Jess, that you're not above going after that 50 grand.
Never, and let me add, neither are you.
No, that's, I'm retired, Jess.
It don't matter, $50,000 will bring you out of retirement quick, Gorilla.
$50,000 won't make or break the Gorilla, Jess, so you can forget about that. Still, with that tremendous ability, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff has met to date every challenger that has been thrust in front of him. This is an awesome individual, but as the body has stated, it certainly is taking its toll mentally, and I'm waiting to see whether it's taking its toll physically. So far, that is not evident.
The next World Wrestling Federation Mat Spectacular in Madison Square Garden will be a holiday mat event. Monday, December 30th, you're going to see the Mighty Midgets on the card. Tony Atlas meets Big John Studd. A tag team title match when champions Greg Valentine and Brutus Beefcake defend against Uncle Elmer and Hillbilly Jim and Macho Man Randy Savage in Madison Square Garden. Monday, December 30th, we'll get the opportunity to become a champion. The World Wrestling Federation champion when he tangles with the one and only Hulk Hogan.
John K9 down and almost out of it. Knee drop right to the sternum area as look out, going to the outside. Paul Orndorff climbing up to that top turnbuckle. So many men doing that today. Oh, what an elbow. Oh, now he's giving a sign for the pile driver. And he's not dedicating it to the body. Oh, just knocked the wind right out of him. Hooked the leg for good measure. It's over. Look out! Ace Orton off the top of the cask. Where did he come from? Out of nowhere.
I don't know, but there's 50,000 bucks, and you can bet the ace is after it.
He ducked out of the way of that one. And maneuvered under that one. Look out now. Slugging it out one-on-one. And Orndorff with a big uppercut sends a cowboy out to the floor. The henchman. Ace Orton. Referee had a hold of Mr. Wonderful and he got a last sucker shot in. He's out of sight now.
That shows you right there, Gorilla, what Mr. Wonderful has to face every day of his life. If it's not Cowboy Bob Orton, it could be anybody.
Everybody and anybody with a vengeance, with the need for that 50 grand ski, is after this man right here, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. And out of the blue and out of the woodwork came the henchman, the number one bodyguard for Rowdy Roddy Piper. Wow, what a shocker. Let's go up and get the official time.
The winner of the match, Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff.
Boy, he's going to have to watch himself in hotel lobbies and parking lots and movie theaters and anywhere he might want to go.
If I was Mr. Wonderful, I would try to make amends with Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, I don't know about that. Let's go back and take a look. Look at this. He saw Orton coming out of the corner of his eye and blocked that shot a little bit with his left hand.
He still got hit with enough of it, though, where it stunned Mr. Wonderful. Mr. Wonderful's down. But fortunately, he blocked enough of it to where he was able to move out of the way. Here comes Orton trying to put the coup de grace on him. Orndorff rolling around, Orton missing and missing, but that's what he's going to face, Gorilla.
Wow, never really landed a full solid blow